Today's video is going to answer the most frequent question anyone planning a wedding or even just team out of curiosity has ever asked. How much does weddings in Ghana cost?
So me my budget, where I do, where I say, oh, maybe if I go marry. If I go high, where I go high, why I say this one, they enter billionaire something before 2005.
So stay tuned. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already to join this ever-growing community. And let's get started. Welcome to Journey to Yes with Nanama. I am Nanama Jimanewua, a wedding planner and coordinator with Dream Wedding Planners, a fashion designer, a wife, a mom, and honestly, I know way too much about the Ghana wedding industry to keep it all to myself. Hence, your new internet bestie who is going to help you plan the most stress-free wedding ever. Journey to Yes with Nanama is a segment on this channel where I share insider tips, advice, and inspirations on how to plan and produce your dream wedding. Before we get started, I would like to thank you for subscribing. It's highly encouraging to know that there are people out there who care or are interested in what I have to say. And if today is your first time here on this channel, kindly subscribe because I have really awesome content coming up and I don't want you to miss it. So hit it right now. For the purpose of this video, and because I'm a Ghana-based wedding planner, all amounts are going to be in Ghana cedis, but it should still give you a rough idea of how weddings generally cost. And feel free to convert to any currency that you are comfortable with. I want to do more of average cost and then the highest cost you should expect when you contact a vendor, because weddings are heavily preference focused, and with that much details, it's impossible to give an exact figure. Typical wedding cost in Ghana is usually 100,000 to 150,000 Ghana cedis for that basic, nothing extravagant sort of wedding, and then 250,000 to 350,000 cedis for standard weddings here in Ghana, and then 500 and above for, you know, more elaborate, more luxurious, all the fireworks sort of wedding, grand weddings. Yeah, you should be looking at 500,000 and above. So I'm going to peg my budgeting at 100 guest counts for the traditional ceremony and 200 to 250 guest counts for the wedding reception. That's the usual or standard guest count here. And so let's say the traditional plus the white wedding reception guest count combined will be 350 guests for the 2 days. First thing we are going to talk about is venue. Very important. There are types of venues, but let's keep it at just outdoor and indoor ceremony venues. And typically, indoors are more expensive than outdoor venue event centers, because for indoors there is energy consumption. I mean, you'll be using ACs, you have the lights on the whole time and all that stuff, a whole lot of other factors. And then sometimes some venues have items like pre-installed items such as trusses, drapery and all that stuff. So indoors tend to be higher than outdoors. For those that do not have those pre-installed items, it tends to get a little bit lower. If you are looking for an indoor venue, especially here in Accra, you should be looking at say 6,000 to 10,000 for average, and as high as 30,000 to 75,000 for the more luxurious ones. Yes. For outdoor venues, you should be looking more at 5,000 for the average, and as high as 20,000 or 30,000 or even more for the more luxurious ones as well. Keep in mind that venue price usually depends on the location of the venue, the number of guests, the amenities that the venue has to offer, and the season you're even getting married in. I have another segment on this channel called Dream Wedding Venue Tour, so you should definitely check that out if you need a venue. Now let's move on to food. So most venues in Ghana allow for outside catering, which is a good thing. And for food, the average that I've seen is around 60 Ghana cedis, and it can go as high as 500 Ghana cedis per head. The average ones can cover your starter, your main meal, and dessert. And that it can go up depending on your location and the kind of food setup you want and a whole lot of other factors. And it can even go down if, say, your mom knows a caterer friend or whatever, they have a family relations or whoever that can cook the food and bring the cost lower. Then that means you'll be paying for just the wedding reception and not the traditional. Then we move on to drinks. Drinks, we have the traditional drinks. You can do cocktail and local bar for traditional, or you can even do just local bar for your traditional and then cocktails for your reception, the white wedding reception. For local bars, you should be looking at average 4,000 Ghana cedis for the average, and then as high as 15,000 cedis for the more detailed ones. And for the reception cocktails, we have non-alcoholic packages and alcoholic packages. And for the non-alcoholic packages, you should be looking at least 6,000 Ghana cedis for the guest count we are illustrating on. And for the alcoholic ones, you should also be looking at 10,000 cedis, and then it can go higher. Next, we talk about photography and videography. Same space, I'm going to keep them together. But I'm going to stick to people like me who cherish their memories. And for photography and videography, let's say you should be looking at 6,000 or 7,000 each. I said each, oh. So don't go and contact your photographer and say, I said 6,000 for both. No, each. And it can even go as high as 30,000 Ghana cedis, again, each. Next on my list is makeup. For professional makeup, you should be looking at 3,000 average and as high as 15,000 cedis for a more luxurious package. And for hair, the same, around the same figure, 3,000 cedis for average and as high as 10,000 cedis. And one thing you have to note is that for hair and makeup, usually the trial and the transportations are usually not included in the packages. Next, we talk about professional MCs, which ranges between 4,000 average to 10,000 cedis average. And Ochiame for the traditional ceremonies are usually around 2,000 cedis to 5,000 cedis. And if you're booking the same person for both days, usually you can get a discount. Next, we have DJ 2, 4,000 average, and then as high as 10,000 or even higher, depending on what you want. And it's also good to know that the more well-seasoned your DJ is, the better for you, because I mean, who is going to bring the groove? I mean, your reception has to be lit, right? Yes. So yeah, DJ, very important. Next, we talk about one of the most controversial topics in the wedding industry, decor. And for decor, you should be looking at 70,000 cedis for a 2 days event average, and as high as 500,000 depending on your taste as well. Then we have your wedding dress and accessories. If a wedding dress, I mean, it entails a lot, so you're going to break that one down. For your kente, the kente fabric, you should be looking at 3,000, 4,000 or even higher if you're going for more detailed kentes, the colors and everything. If you're customizing it, there's a lot of factors that go into the kente. So the list for kente can be 3,000 or 4,000 each. That's if the groom will also be donning or, let's say, wrapping the kente, that one to them. That means you have to buy kente for both yourself and the groom as well. For the kente sewing itself, you should be looking at average 2,500 to even as high as 10,000 Ghana cedis for the sewing. Then we have reception fabric too. It depends on the number of yards you are sewing, depends on the style. So for reception fabric, you should be looking at, say, average 2,500, 3,000 cedis for the lace, the average lace. And even as high as 10,000 or even 20,000 cedis for the number of yards you want of a particular lace. Then we now come to the wedding dress itself. The wedding dress itself also, I mean, both the fabric and the sewing, you should be looking at 7,000, 8,000 or even 10,000 for average, and it can go as high as 25, 30 or even 40,000 cedis. Headpieces, crowns, tiaras, 300 to 500 would do. Earrings, 50 cedis to as high as 300 cedis for your bridal earrings. Bridal robes, 800 average to 3,000 or 5,000 cedis, depending on the style you want to for you. Bridesmaids, bridal robes, bridesmaids robes should be around 150 cedis to 300 cedis or 400 cedis. And shoes is more preference based, so I'm not going to talk about that one. Yes, so that's all for the wardrobe and accessories. Bouquets, hand fans, you should be looking at 500, 600 cedis on average, and it can go as high as 1,000 or 1,500 cedis. One thing to note is that bouquets, there are two types. They are the artificial flowers bouquet and then the natural flowers bouquet. So it depends on what you want done for you. And then bridesmaids bouquet, that can go for 50 cedis or even 100 cedis, again, on the style or the size of what you want. Boutonnieres, groom's boutonnieres too, can go for 30, 40 cedis on average. So for suits, depending on the detailing you want, you should be looking on average 4,000 cedis, and it can even go as high as 10,000 cedis, depending on the detailing, again. Then we talk about cake. For cake, it will depend on the number of tiers you want and even the flavors you want made for you and even the person making the cake. So for cake, it will be let's say 2,500 cedis on average, and it can even go as high as 20,000 or even 30,000 or even more depending on what you want. I mean, it's all about the design and the creativity of the person. We now move to my space and my most favorite thing to do, wedding planning. And for wedding planning, the pricing packages usually comes in three ways. We have those that would take a percentage of your entire wedding budget, and usually like 10% or 20% of your budget, your entire wedding budget. And there are those that will give you a rate card, and in the rate card they have different pricing structures, and then you have to choose which one works for you. Then we have the, that one is not so common here in Ghana, so I'm not going to spend time to talk about it, and that's the hourly charge. But just to know that there's something like that out there. There is coordination, which is also under wedding planning. And FYI, let me just put it out there, coordination is a non-negotiable vendor. At this point, coordination should even become an essential worker. So for coordination, unless you plan to split yourself into two, I will highly advocate that you get yourself a coordinator. If not a wedding planner, get yourself a coordinator, please. And if you are trying to do prepare and you say, oh, I'll ask this family member or this close friend of mine to take care of things, by the time you realize, they'll be sitting there conversing with family members or friends that they've not seen in a very long time. And then who will do the coordination for you? And once you think of a coordination, you can get it as low as 2,500 cedis for a day of coordinator. So tell me, why would you risk such an important day in your life for something as low as 2,500 cedis?
Oh wow.
For those who keep asking, I have a video coming up about the difference between a wedding planner and a coordinator, and even the types of wedding planners out there. So this will be a very good time to hit that subscribe button. Moving on now to stationery, which is also part of the per person packages, or depends on the quantity you want. Stationery, you should be looking at 20 cedis for, and there are types of stationery, but I mean, let's group them all into stationery. Stationery, you should be looking at 20 cedis on average per person, or per the quantity you want. Then we have live bloggers, if that's your vibe. For live blogging, you should be looking at 1,500 or 2,500 cedis on average, and as high as 8,000 or 10,000 cedis. It all depends on the person's reach and popularity. Room decor, as usual, depends on your taste, but you should be looking at 1,000 cedis on average, and it can even go as high, depending on what you want, as high as 5,000 or 7,000 Ghana cedis for room decor alone. Favor bags, another per person packaging. It depends on what you want to gift your guest. Some can do as low as pupu bowls, and for that you can even get it for 20 cedis or 25 cedis. So it all depends on what you want to gift your guests. And then we have portable toilets. Portable toilets are for those who do not want their guests coming in and out of their houses during their traditional wedding ceremony. For portable toilets, you should be looking at on average 800 cedis for their least packages, their basic packages, and it can go higher. I mean, depending on the kind of portable toilet you want, you should be looking at 3,000 or 4,000 or even 5,000 cedis, depending on, again, what you want. This video is getting really long, and there is so much I've still not talked about. I've not talked about rings, security, live band, cultural troop, transportation, ushers, dowry packaging, contingency money, buffer, as we call it, for any emergency or things that may go out of what you were expecting. If you want a part two of this video, want me to give pricing on the things that I just mentioned, leave a comment below, and then there will be a part for you. If I also forgot something, please comment below so that it can help those who are also in need of such information. Weddings are expensive,
we know,
but from this illustration you now know that everything is completely up to you. Like the account proverb, pancha de efe, yeah, this kind of eto. What you want is what you get. What you want your wedding to look like is exactly how it will look like. And the funny thing about weddings is that the more you try to cut down, the more you end up spending. Hey! Little disclaimer here. My goal is not to undermine any vendor. All the prices I've been stating are figures I have seen and worked with. So like we keep saying, I mean, I've overused the word preference in this video. It's all up to you and what you want and what you deem important generally. Someone will say that to them, food is more important than any part of their wedding. Another will say that their outfit is more important to them in any than all the other parts of the wedding. So it's more about what you want, what you tell your planner, and what we focus more on when it comes to your budgeting. I sincerely hope that this video has and will be beneficial to every intending couple.
Yes.
Because I'm tired of the bashing culture that follows such videos. If every couple keeps choosing a particular vendor, of course, he or she will now try to charge higher to limit herself to a particular group of interest. Higher demand is equal to exclusivity. It's the basic law of nature. Some vendors increased their pricing by 150% in 2023 alone. Why? They are sought after.
Okay.
So if you decide no matter what, that vendor is who you want, changing how you want to book that vendor, then it's no more the industry problem. It's a you problem.
Hey!
Well, the industry is so vast that there are hundreds of people doing the exact same thing. So don't turn a blind eye and then go around shouting, Ghana wedding industry is expensive, they are ripping us off, everybody is cheating us, and all that stories. It is still about your taste. To counter what I just said, the fact that I said there are hundreds of people doing the exact same thing doesn't mean that you go looking for cheap because you are now being frugal. Different vendors offer different services and their level of expertise. There is cheap and there is quality but affordable. I remember a wedding my husband shot a few years ago, and during the bridal dress up, the people in the room, they were all praising the bride on how nice her hair and makeup looks. And instead of quietly basking in the praises, that's when she chose to condemn the high paying or the high charging makeup and hairstylists in the industry. And this part is what my husband calls instant karma. When the makeup and hair was done, and before she even got to the church, her frontal was going backwards. And by the time they got to the reception, her frontal was halfway back and her makeup was dripping. Pricing comes with experience. And the deeper you get into something, the more you realize the worth of that thing. I always tell my couple that these vendors that you are terming as cheap, they are not fools, they are cheap for a reason. Their pricing is bait and you are the fish. You are an experiment to them. They are using you to hone their craft. Immediately they become experienced, they will become inaccessible to you. Humans are wired to be selfish. With all that has been said, my advice to young people, I was going to say ladies, but I realized that it's a general problem because the man has a way of making it feel like the money that you need for weddings, to fund weddings, unless you take IMF loans, it won't be possible. So my advice to young people is that when you get to a marriageable age, update yourself with, every year, update yourself with the general wedding cost so that by the time you get there, it won't be a surprise to you. This will keep you informed when you are saving towards it so that you don't create a huge sum in your mind thinking it's a huge figure, and then you get to the actual wedding and you realize that it can't even cater for like 20% of the entire wedding, the kind of wedding that you want. I have a sister, even without a boyfriend, she has special funds for just weddings. Like she just saves, she has a bank account that she saves for just weddings. With such a person, when it's time for her wedding, there's nothing that will be too much for her to purchase or to book or to order. This may touch a nerve, but try and keep your wedding guest list small. The largest consumer of your wedding budget are usually food, venue, decor, favors, stationery and all that stuff. So if you keep your guest list small, definitely those things will also come down. I have another video coming up on the strategic ways of saving money whilst planning your wedding. So stay tuned for that by hitting the subscribe button. If you found this video helpful, or it even lessened your stress, your wedding stress, just a tiny bit, please leave an encouraging comment below and give me a thumbs up. You can also comment below if you have any questions or topics you want us to discuss in relation to wedding planning. And don't forget to follow my socials linked below. And if you're in need of my wedding planning services, kindly feel free to send me an email or WhatsApp me on the details on your screen. See you in my next video and happy planning. Bye bye.